She's not just an orphan, she's a fucking maniac! Tonight, Jamie Power back for a very short movie review today, and today I want to talk to you about the new film Orphan First Kill, a prequel to the 2009 film, yes, 13 years ago, Orphan, which was a very good film. I loved it, saw it at the cinema, loved it to pieces, and now we've got a prequel, I was going to say sequel, but it's a prequel, and if you haven't seen the first film, I do highly recommend you watch that one first before this one. So, what's the story? Well, we catch up with Esther. She goes into another family and all things go to hell. And that's all you need to know. I'm not going to tell you anything else about the story because you need to see this film with fresh eyes. Don't watch any trailers if you can help it. Just know that this is a prequel. But I was really surprised because when I saw the trailer, I didn't go much on it. I thought, yeah, it looks quite good. I'll go see it. And then it came out and I went and saw it and I was really surprised. I actually really enjoyed this film. It does feel like a little bit of a low budget film, but it's very well done. And obviously this is set years later and it's a prequel, so the girl is meant to look younger. And I think they did quite a good job. I mean, there wasn't too much. I mean, the trailer looked a bit obvious at times, but they've done a good job here. I didn't really notice it. And yeah, I thought they did a really good job with the makeup and all the effects and everything that they could do to make this work. And they did. They made this work very well. I think the story is very strong in this one. Really enjoy the story. It goes at a really good pace. The beginning is very exciting. The middle is interesting. And the third act is pretty good. I like the ending. A lot of people say that the ending is a bit abrupt, but I can see where they're coming from as well. But I don't like endings that are dragged out and it just goes on and on and on. And monologues from characters saying this, that, the other. And this just gets to the point and gets on with it. And I didn't mind that for a fresh take. So I thought the film was very well acted. It was very well written. I like how the story progressed and the twists and turns that this film takes. It's very well made. The cinematography at times is great. The music fits the film perfectly. It's a very polished film. It's not perfect, don't get me wrong. But I really enjoyed it. About halfway through, something happens and you're like, fuck. Okay, we're going down this road. And you didn't expect it. I didn't see it coming. And I thought, wow, these films are great. If they can make another one of these, I'm happy to watch it. It was so good, and I think the characters, the act, like I said, everything about this film I thought was top notch. Really enjoyed it. It's not perfect, but it's a very entertaining prequel, and like I said, make sure you watch the first one first. I know this is a prequel, like I said, but make sure you see it first, because a lot of things are revealed in the beginning of this film that you know by the end of the original one. So, that's it. So if I was to rate this film out of 5, I'm going to go 4 stars. Yes, 4 stars, quite high, but I just loved it. I really got into it, and yeah, for an hour and a half, it goes at a very good pace. It's not boring at all. And yeah, you want to know what's going to happen. And yeah, that's it. That's all I can say for the film. Make sure you go and see it. Give this film some support. And that's my review. Thanks for watching. Have you seen it? Let me know down in the comments. What do you think about it? And please like, share, and subscribe. Stay safe, play safe. And bye for now.